friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you stop living in chaos one organizing project at a time. In this video, I'm going to show you how I use a binder to organize information that I need to access on a regular basis or for reference. So I showed in a recent video how I downloaded the complete guide to home canning and put it in a binder. It's the same type of organization that I use for my recipe binder. I'll put a link to that video in the iCards above. And it's also the same organization that I use for my emergency binder. I also did a video on that and I'll link that in the iCards above. So let's get to it. Okay. So here's the binder. I had printed out the complete guide to home canning from the website. I'll put a link in the description box below. This binder is from Staples. It is called their Staples Better Binder, and it really is a great binder. I have several of these and use them for organization. I've tried all kinds of binders, and definitely I go with this when I want to keep something long term. I do have other binders, as you'll see in a little while, that I like them because they look nice. I wouldn't say these for me are as artsy as I would want them to be, if that's the right word. But they are very durable and they're worth the price. They range, I think, from $7 to $9. I'm not sure how much they are now, but I'll put a link also to the Staples website. You want to get it there or go to the store, because they are definitely more expensive on Amazon. But if that's your only choice, then get them on Amazon. So I've just printed out the complete guide to home canning and put it on the side, on the spine. Of course, you can use the paper in there, put it on there. I just like to put it on top. It's just a lot easier. Or if I ever want to change out the binder, it's easier just to take the label off. Of course, you don't need to use a label maker. You could write it, you can put stickers, you can use markers, you can do whatever you want, but just make sure to label the spine. I've been asked what label maker I use. So this is actually a Martha Stewart box I've had for many, many years from Staples. You can get them there at Staples now, different design. And then also the Bigzo brand at the Container Store. You can also buy label things like this separately. So again, I've used the label maker to label my label maker box. And it is a Brother P-Touch. I've had this for over 15 years. It has never broken, knock on wood. And so I recommend it. I had gotten this from Costco as a bundle. Once in a while, they'll have it out. There is a newer version of the P-Touch, I believe. I'll also put a link there. And then inside, you could see that I put a stock of labels in here. They do come in different sizes. I also tried to use different colors, but I do prefer the black on the white. Okay, it's just easier to read. And that's what I have on most of my binders. The other tools you'll see here are these tabs, post-it tabs. These are a wonderful invention. You can see they come with 24 tabs, so you can do a lot of binder organization with these. They come in different colors. There's like a neon type color and then the basic colors like red, blue. So I think these are the basic colors here. Okay, so you can see I have several boxes in these. Use them a lot. So there's basic colors like this, blue, red, yellow, green, and then you have the neon type colors like that. You also wanna get sheet protectors. These were 88 cents at Walmart, and of course, since it's school supplies time, you're gonna find these everywhere. There are the standard weight, and then there are the heavier weight. So for something like this, where there's a lot of printouts, I go ahead and got the more, I guess, the efficient weight, much cheaper. You'll see there's a difference when you flip the pages, but since it's not something I'm going to be flipping through every day, it's only gonna be the days that I'm gonna be canning, I figured this would be okay. And plus it does add thickness to the overall depth of the binder, so you may want to get the thin ones, but again, I usually get the standard and I like those. They come in 20 count. They also come in 50, 100 count, even higher than that, I believe. You can get them at any big box store or any office supply store and on Amazon. The reason I like a binder organization for reference items like this that I'll be using every so often is because when I'm in the kitchen, I can lay it out flat like this. Even if you have a book stand, you could lay it flat on the book stand, and it's just easy to flip through. I also like the sheet protectors actually protect the sheets. And when you're dealing with liquid and steam, I just think it's a better option than just having the pages out. If you don't plan to have sheet protectors, you will need the three-hole puncher, and you just hole punch the paper. And so here you could see at the top, oh, see, the other thing with this binder is you could flip it like this way and it does not break, okay? And there is this thing here. It's so easy to open. Okay, love that. Other ring binders, you have to pull like this. And I mean, of course you can open it, but those who, you know, are more sensitive with the strength in their forearms or fingers, it does make a difference. Okay, so here I use those tabs, those post-it note tabs, to put the tabs, okay, or the categories. So luckily this printout, this guide, has the chapter. It's organized by the type of food item that's going to be canned. So first it begins with the principles, then it shows how to can fruit, tomatoes, different types of vegetables, meat, and seafood. You can see here seafood back there. Things that will be pickled, and then jams and jellies. So I can just put my finger on this tab and pull straight to that section. Principles of home canning, go to the fruit, pull straight to that section. Okay, so I put it on the front page here. That's what it looks like. And so what you've noticed with different tab dividers, when you close the binder like this, like, you don't know where the tabs are. And here you can see the tabs. It makes it a lot easier to flip through. And the ones that have tabs here, you know, like those paper dividers, or sometimes they're laminated, sometimes they have a pocket and you could put a cover sheet in it. Bottom line, the tabs are here. So you're not gonna see it when you're looking on top there. You're gonna have to flip through to find the tab, just like this, see? I mean, this is part of the printout, but that's what happens. You have to flip through to find it, and it just makes it so much easier having these types of tabs. Let's look at the other things in this book. Tomatoes, okay? And the nice thing is, example, they have recipes here, salsa recipes. And in the beginning part, there's a lot of information. So like general acidification, what to do with tomato juice. And they even have here, like style of pack, jar size, process time, canner pressure at altitudes of, you know, wherever you're living. So, I mean, it really is a complete guide. Other people have suggested the ball guide to canning, which I've heard that's also good. So I just wanted to start with this, since it was recommended by the Needy Homesteader. And here, veggies, meat and seafood. So let's look at that. For me, meat is going to be the one that I'm interested in really learning, because you can only have corned beef and Spam for so long. Yeah, so it's hot and raw. Okay, there's hot. Okay, let me see. Oh, they have clams. That will be interesting. Love to make clam chowder. Fish. Oh, this is exciting. I'm really looking forward to canning. I'm a completely beginner, newbie canner. And jams and jellies, we've made jams and jellies, but I've never canned it for long term. We've gone through it during the season, so looking forward to that, because I do want to make fig spread. That is something that for me is expensive and my family loves it. Okay, so that's the end. So on this part, you can take your sheet protectors and create a whole new category for yourself. Maybe you have recipes from your grandmother, your mom, your own recipes. you may want to print out recipes from the internet or your favorite YouTuber, things like that. So you can always add a section when you're using binder organization, the sheet protectors, and the tabs. So this is to show you how a binder organization can work for something like a book or a recipe book. This is my binder for my go-to recipe. So I only put here the recipes that I actually use. I don't stock up on different recipe books, and I think I got rid of 5 to 10 of them, and I don't miss them. I pulled out the recipes that I really enjoy there. And so I'll just put a link in the iCards above so you can see the full tour. I have a pencil bag here with little post-it note markers, you know, or to mark your page. And I just cut out file folders to fit so that it's prettier. You can even have recipe cards with different types of sheet protectors. And then here, what I could add as a different category, because I have appetizers, entrees, sides, I can add a category just for using prepped items when I actually go to cook them. Here's the last binder I'm gonna show you in this video. I do have other binders, but this is what I'll show you, and I'll put a link in the iCards. This is my emergency preparedness binder, and I haven't changed this yet, but I will be adding, since it's September is National Preparedness Month, I will be adding these things from ready.gov. And I'll be going through that in maybe a couple of videos in September, but it's a great resource. You know, there's different websites, different preppers, they have great resources. And what I like to try to do is find the ones that have like a printable something. And I find checklists, information put into printable things are a lot easier for me to follow. And so that may be the case for you, or free printables, right? They're just good things to have. Like here, FEMA has a checklist here. And then the other thing is someone had recommended that I can print out recipes and put it on the back of my number 10 cans, since who knows, you know, where my binders will be in 30 years and who will have my number 10 cans. I told my kids that will be part of their inheritance. But you can find recipes, maybe they're printable, they can be in a book, you can cut them out of the book and maybe laminate, put them in sheet protectors and put it with the cans or on the back of the cans. So that's what I'm planning on doing, is finding recipes, putting them in my emergency preparedness binder, because for me, in my mind, they go better here than my recipe book. So these are recipes I'm only going to use during an emergency, when I'm going to my emergency food. But it's up to you. It just depends on how you think. If you're the way you think is that these should be with my recipes, and I'll just flip to the category of prep food or prepper food, then that's fine. Whatever works for you and your brain, you know, it has to function for you. Organization is a system that you set in place that works for how you live and how you work and how you think. Not how I work, not how I think, or not how he or she or they think, okay? It's for you, you do it for yourself. Okay, so here in Arizona, we go through dust storms, flood, fire, power outage. These are things that are specific to our area, so you will be thinking of things specific to your area. The other thing is that we have documents here. So this binder is meant to grab in an emergency. I have copies of my important documents here, birth certificate, marriage certificate, passports, etc. So it serves me as a reference, and it also serves us as a grab and go binder. If we are bugging out, it's right by my first aid kit. I just grab it with me. All our documents are here. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below if you've started canning. What are you using for your guide? If you have any links, put them in the links below. Also in my community tab, in my stories, I put some information there this past week of places where you can find mason jars and pressure canners. And of course they go quickly, so I will, if I find anything up to date, I'll post it right away. hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Is the clutter in your home leaving you exhausted? I can help you stop living in chaos. Go to my website and schedule a free 20-minute virtual home organizing assessment. SimplySherry.com. Click the pink button, Get Organized Today. It'll bring you to a page for Calendly. Choose the time that works for you and you will receive an email with a Zoom call link. I look forward to helping you. All this time you thought would never pay the price.